Hello, welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're now in... We're about to be boarding... Disembarking... Procedure to Aprout? Aprout? I don't know how to say that. Which is in some place called... Another World. Mitchell says, we have no idea how the people in another world live. Let's just be careful so that we don't attract attention. And just to reconfirm, Forte and Una shouldn't use any offensive resonance spells. Which we hardly ever use those anyway, so that's fine. It's the defensive ones, like the healing and stuff, that we really want. Okay, says Forte. I understand, says Una. Okay, trying to move forward, and the otherworldly boy says, wow, what a big ship. I've never seen a ship this big. Grandpa says, I wonder where this ship is from. I didn't know that Merville had such a large ship. Merville? Huh? It's such a big boat. I've never seen a boat this big. Is this the new boat for Queen Merville? Oh, Merville is a queen. Queen Merville? Asked Forte. No, we came from a place far away, says Mitchell. I thought it was the Queen's boat. I guess I was wrong. You were wrong. Dead wrong. And then we kill him. Alright.
Where did you come from anyway? You seem like you're from another world.
Yes, we're from the uncapitalized another world. I came from Weltluna, says Forte. I'm from Tiras Wheel, says Mitchell. And I'm from El Filden, says Avon. You just realize, yeah, we got people from all three. Just wish we could have the main protagonist from Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. That'd be even more awesome. I forgot who they are.
Tiras Wheel? Well, Luna? El what? I'd bite my tongue trying to say names like those. I've never heard of them. I haven't set foot out of Aprout in over 10 years, so I only know about this area of Merville. All I do is go visit the Queen's Palace in Esfin, north from here, about once a year.
Once a year, okay.
Let's go this way.
Okay. Going on like some small peninsula or something. Very thin peninsula. Oh, we can't go that way. Oh, hello there, green-haired girl. Back here, I'm a green-haired boy. My grandma tells me that the otherworldly moon is bigger than it was when she was a small child. But there's no way for me to tell because I've never seen it as it was when my grandma was a kid. Anyway, you're looking for someone, aren't you? How did you know? Says Forte. You don't need to be so surprised. My power is clairvoyance. I don't get in trouble for using it, though. I don't know the details, but you don't seem like bad people, so I'll tell you. The hint for the person you're looking for lies in the Queen's Palace.
Queen's Palace?
He likes to repeat things. It's where Queen Merville lives. It's in Esfin, north from here.
Alright. Ah, very interesting.
Oh wait, we can go out this way. Is that the same girl? Oh, no, this is a woman. You're not from around here, are you? Did you come to see the Queen's Palace in Esfin? Well, yes, says Mitchell. You came to see where Queen Merville, the Queen of Merville, lives, huh? Wow, that was complicated to say.
So then, why'd you say it that way?
It's confusing that the Queen's name and the world's name is the same.
Oh, it is. Okay.
But there's nothing we can do about it. This world was named after the first queen. So this is the land of Merveel. Once the next queen officially ascends to the throne, she takes on the name Merveel. This will go on forever. Yes, she has clairvoyance as well. Well, more like foretelling the future. It'll be confusing forever then, Asuna? Yes, it seems that way. Esfin is a nice place. The Queen's Palace on the lake is a must-see. Talking to us like we're tourists. Alright, is this to rent a room? Oh, you don't seem familiar. Well, maybe it's just our house. It's hard to travel from town to town in Merveel because of the Neverdawn land and all the monsters. Okay, Neverdawn, I guess, means it's always night. We can't travel far without a boat, and even though we live on the same continent, we seldom see people from other lands. Yeah, it's her house. Is that the same one? Did she have that hat? I think so. Yeah, Esfin. What's this? I don't know. Alright, let me in. Hi. Otherworldly villager. This area is away from the path of the otherworldly moon, so we're not affected by it. But the areas directly underneath the path of the otherworldly moon are affected by it over a long period of time. People can't live there anymore. We refer to those areas as the Neverdawn land. Oh, I thought this whole place was a Neverdawn land. Like, I thought Neverdawn land was kind of like a descriptor for what kind of land this is, and this is a land where the sun doesn't come up. But I'm guessing this place is fine. It just happens to be night right now. Did you come here to escape the Neverdawn land too? No, we came from farther away, asked Mitchell. I see. I hear that once a land is affected by the otherworldly moon, everything goes crazy, and there are many ferocious monsters. It's so scary. Just so scary. Whoops. Oh. Boy says, okay, whoever can use the greatest magic wins. The girl says, sure, okay, I'm gonna win anyway. Let's do it before we get interrupted. The boy says, heh, you think you can win, huh? Of course. Okay, let's find out who can cast the best fire spell, aimed over there. Okay. Alright, I'm going first, says the boy. Yeah. How ferocious. That's nothing, says the girl. It's my turn now. A voice from a villager says, hey! Uh-oh, says the boy. I've told you that you're not allowed to use offensive spells. How many times do I have to tell you? If a soldier sees you, it's not going to be as easy as paying a fine, you know. Yeah, that's why they left to this world in the first place. I'm sorry, please keep this a secret. Even if there's a notice issued by the Queen, little kids want to test out the strengths that they're born with. It's in their nature. Please forgive them. I forgive them. Forte says, he just said that they're born with those powers, didn't he? The people here can cast magic spells since they were born, says Una. But it didn't seem like it was a resonance spell, Forte says. Mitchell says, it seems like it's different from the magic that Arya and I have acquired through training. He said they weren't allowed to use attack spells, says Una. But I wonder if it's to prevent the mass of harmful frequencies from being affected. Is it okay to use other spells? It's hard to know the details, says Mitchell. We have no idea how much they know. And about Leon, too. If we can, I'd like to go and talk to the Queen directly.
Yeah, well, that's the goal.
So where's the person who was, Oh, that's the kids there. Alright, let's go talk to them. Someone got mad at me, says the boy. Yeah, I noticed. I screwed up. Alright, they don't have much to say. What about that soldier? Well, I haven't gone in here. This is someone we have to talk to. Oops. Esfin. Lies to the north. Yeah, I guess we'll... I think this is the only other person we have to talk to is in here. Let me in.
It could be just me, but I have this feeling that the otherworldly moon is getting bigger every year.
Otherworldly moon? Asked Forte to himself, I guess.
It just seems so much bigger than it was when I was growing up.
Oh, that's what that girl was talking about.
I have this feeling that the moon is expanding. Don't you feel that way?
Can I ask you something? Says Una. Alright, Una, you just did.
What's that?
Una asked the old lady if she'd ever seen a man fitting the description of Leon.
Oh, you're looking for someone. I haven't seen any strangers except for you lot for a long time. Oh, my husband saved a drifter when he was out fishing one time. Sorry, used the wrong word.
A drifter, says Una. Can you tell us more about that person?
I'm sorry. I don't remember much. It was so long ago. Why don't you ask my husband? He's probably hanging out at the docks.
Oh, he is. Okay.
My husband is the kind of guy that hangs around the docks, so don't trust him too much.
Nice.
But he's always happy to talk about the days when he used to fish. Why don't you go listen to him?
What, is he going to mug me or something? What's going to happen? Alright, let's go talk to him at the docks. I talked to that grandma, and I can't talk to him about that. Talk to the grandma. Okay. Oh, it was her who said that. Unless it was you. Alright. Back to the docks. From whence we came. The hell was that? Oh, the mast of the boat. Oh, is he's one of these two people that we already talked to. Is he got anything new to say? Oh yeah, apparently. I can't believe that there's such a big ship in the world. It's almost like it came from another world. That reminds me, I remember my grandpa saying that he met a drifter many years ago that seemed like he came from another world. Oh, we can get back on the ship? Good. Don't rush things just because you don't have much time. Be sure to rest and replenish frequently. Sometimes it'll take longer if you're not prepared adequately. I heard the new weapons we brought along have finally become available. If you haven't seen them, you should go check them out at the arms dealer. Is that a new thing he said? Let me just check around here. That's the same thing he said. Yeah, I'm gonna bet that no one else has anything new to say.
I still remember that day. I remember saving a drifter that came here. He seemed like he was from another world. He wasn't as fancy as you people, though.
A drifter that seemed like he was from another world, says Mitchell.
Yeah, I was somewhat of a famous fisherman in my younger days. I was known as the young reckless sailor that would go out to sea all by myself. And I saved a man that was drifting in the ocean. If I wasn't there, he probably would have ended up as shark food.
Do you remember his name, Esforte?
No, I forgot. I do remember that he had a name, though.
Was his name Leon, Asuna?
I really forgot. It was many years ago.
What do you mean he seemed like he was from another world, Esforte?
My instincts told me so. Like, he ate different foods or had different habits. I just knew he was different.
Says Forte. We can't really tell if the person you saved is the same person we're looking for.
Oh, you were looking for someone? Then you should go to the Queen's Palace in Esfin. The drifter asked me where the person of the highest power was, so I told him that she was at the Queen's Palace in Esfin.
Huh? Says Forte.
If you go ask at the Queen's Palace, there might be some record of him.
Wow, what a huge clue, says Forte. Thanks, Grandpa.
Hey, it'll make McBain jealous, unless he's not with us.
Same? Okay. Let's see. Now that I talk to him, what does she have to say?
You were forced to listen to his stories when you used to go out fishing, weren't you? Sorry about all the trouble.
No, not at all, says Una. Thanks to that, we were able to hear the story about the drifter.
That was good. I hope that drifter is the person you're looking for.
How helpful. I didn't mean to hit it again and again. Alright, I guess we're going to the Queen's Palace in Esfin. Save the game. Nothing to buy here, or no quest to do. We're beginning to understand, says Mitchell. It seems that the Dark Sun is referred to here as the Otherworldly Moon. I'm curious about the Never Dawn Land, says Forte. It seems like it's an area contaminated by the Otherworldly Moon. Yeah, I guess just covered with darkness, right? From the Dark Sun. It seems like we should first go north to Esfin, where the Queen's Palace is, says Avon. If Leon is the kind of person that we think he is, Mitchell says, he would have thought of some answer once he understood the problem. If the leader of this world is a queen, there's a high possibility that he was connected to that queen. Let's go north to the Queen's Palace, says Una. What's this? This is the fossil forest, isn't it? Says Mitchell. It's a little lonely, Una says. But it's a mystical view. Yes, says Forte. This is another world. We don't see this kind of view in Weltluna. It's really a magical world. What's that? Says Una. Wow, it's so pretty, says Una. It's probably about to attack us in some way. Look, Forte. Is that a firefly? He asked. I wonder what they're called here. Death bugs. Alright, roll for initiative. It's beautiful, says Avon. Bwahahaha, says Mile. Why are you laughing like that?
What? Says Una.
Somehow it doesn't quite fit you to look at the firefly and say it's beautiful. Avon says, man, even I have an appreciation for things that are beautiful, you know? Sorry, sorry. Just smile. So, okay, so it's not attacking. Fossil Forest, beware of monsters, children prohibited without supervision. Well, we got supervision. I guess we have Mitchell. I mean, technically the rest of us are kids, right? I mean, I don't know how old a dog is in dog years. And that we've got rat years. Alright. I was just curious, because we like cinematically went into this place. Alright. What is this thing? It doesn't want to fight us, so I guess we'll leave it alone. Not used to things shying away from us. They're all afraid. It's like we're on the moon. Oh, what are all these things? Are these chests or something? It is. We got a leash bottle M. That's the cure medium. Doesn't look like they're from the other side, like the other chest. Cure bottle M. Oh no, leash bottle M. Sorry, that's Magicka. Cure bottle M. That's a medium healing. Cure moderate wounds, whatever. And another one of those tarps. Awesome. But those tarps are really good. That's not even a potion. It's an item, I think. Yeah. Full restore hit point, magic point, and all negative effects. We have six of them. That's awesome. Been picking them up, and I never used them, so... This is a different color here. Look at this. Nothing. There's another chest. Leash bottle L. Well, the bad news is, so that's the large Magicka potion. Bad thing is, purify potion. Cool. They're giving us all these potions, you know it's gonna be hard. Forget what is purify removes all negative effects, I think. Just wanna see how much we have of this stuff. Okay, 5 resurrection powders, 9 panacea potions, 7 restore snuff, 4 lackety paste. Lackety pasty, 10 purify potions now. Neutralizes poison. I usually don't bother to cure poison. I just wait till the battle's over, and then the poison's gone, and then I just heal up the hit points. But maybe we should use some of these purify potions. It takes a turn for the character to take it, so I don't bother. 5 leash bottle L's. I don't think we've ever had that many. 8 of the medium, 7... Oh no, we used the, 7 of the cure bottle L's. 2 cure bottle M's, and we don't have the small ones. I used the small ones outside of combat. Just to top us off, and had very little magic. Oh, look at this. More chests. Tranquil snuff. Alright, that stops panic. Let's see how many of those we have now. And another cure bottle M. This is gonna be hard, isn't it? how much stuff they're giving us? Tranquil snuff. Oh, we used them all. So anti-panic.
Is this back by the... No. I thought we were back by the entrance to the town. That's over here, though. Alright, have I seen everything then? I think... I don't want to miss any more of those chests. If it's going to be hard, I want to, you know... have everything that's available. Back for those chests. And these chests. Okay, so the way out is west, I take it? So we are supposed to go north, but of course, as you know, it's never going to be directly north, probably. At least this time it's not, so. Should we... I kind of hate fighting these things that don't want to fight us, but... We need a bow for Una, and I want to go back to the town and get it. We probably surprised the enemy. The floaters. Check out this music. Oh, I like it. I like the beat. Trying to figure out, maybe it has like a little bit of like a science fiction, you know, kind of like tint to it. Oh, I like that. This part's cool. I'm like rocking out over here. I'm sure if we were like a level or two lower, they'd be after us, so. They're not that innocent. They look like tentacles that wear robes, though. 102 roses. The others ran away. Okay. These things are no match for us. We keep surprising them, so I don't think we've seen them even attack yet. It's a tentacle with some kind of robes. Is that a robe? Or like a carapace or something? Oh, Miles gonna waste his turn. Yeah, we got the steam attack now. Missed! Here comes this one. Missed. And we got all full meters. Oh, there's another chest there. I didn't even see that. Probably wouldn't have seen it if I hadn't stopped, paused to get into a battle there. One-shotted.
Damn. Yeah. Two-shotted. Marbles.
So you have some of those marbles already, you just never used them. And I figured now they'd be completely, like, weak. Yeah. Only throw them at monsters. Not your friends. It's a cautionary tale about marbles. I want to fight like two more and then we'll go see if we have enough back at the ship. Oh, we got a shell also. That's the shell. Interesting. Yeah, I made a mistake at the end of last episode, or the last 20 minutes of the last episode, where I sold Una's bow and figured, oh, we have enough for the next bow. But I was looking at the wrong bow. I was looking at the fairy bow, and I was like, oh, we need 6,000 for that. And the other one's like an oak bow or elm bow or something, and that's the better one, and that's actually 8,000. So we had 7,000 and change, and wasn't enough. And I'm like, well, I could buy back her old bow, but I'd be losing money. So screw that, right? I'm like, let's just get some money. Hope we can get back on the boat, because sometimes the game doesn't let you go back to other places. But now it seems to be that you can. Oh, it actually hit the dog for 86 points. You're toast, buddy. We can bash you around all we want, but hit our dog? Mm-mm. Everyone swarm Floater B. He is filth! The shell missed. It'll be the last thing he ever misses. Oh, nice, we got a cure bottle L. How many cure bottle L's do we have? 8. One more. How many roses do we have? Yeah. I want to get to like 500 roses. Maybe that'll make 1,000 gents. I'm not sure if it's one rose makes 2 gens? It might be even higher than that. Look at that, we've got this like corridor inside the walls. Can we get in there? Look at that. There's a space in there. I mean, I don't see anything in there. You never know, it might be hidden past something in the darkness there. There's another one here. And you have these dark areas, like, makes you think that someday we'll be, like, walking around in there. Here's another one. Well, that one's wide open. I think we killed all the monsters here, so we need to zone out and come back. Apparently only 4 groups of monsters. Oh, monsters! I want to kill you!
Enemy is surprised.
B and C. Finish him off, Jan. And Rick. Shell fights back. Yeah, I guess they decided to make this part easier. Because the other monsters are tougher than this, and they were not running from us, they were coming at us. Another cure bottle L, so now we have 9 of them. Alright, let's... I think we can rest on the ship. Can we rest on the ship? I like how when you get closer to the shore that the sound of the water just fades gradually in. Pretty cool. It's a small thing, I know, but it's like, I notice things like that. Alright, so... it's down here. Yes. Let's do the exchange. Right, 7051 gents. Nice. Oh no, I was wrong. 5 gents for every rill. 5 gents for every rill. Sorry. Brinny. Alright, so now buy the ash bow. That's what it is. 8,000 gents. Bow made of ash. 3 thin plates are laminated for added power. So compared to the fairy bow, which I sold back by mistake, it's another 13 attack and then another 1 defense. I guess she holds the bow out and blocks attacks with it. I guess that's how that works. And there's nothing to sell since we already sold her other bow. Poor Una. Here you go. That should be better for you. Yeah, just Ruka's down here. It's the only thing to find, other thing to find down here. And I have a problem with my left directional. Good thing I'm not playing an action game. So that's an item shop. Just want to see if there's anything. These are 1,200. Let me give you a few more restore snuff. Give me 2 more. Lackney pace of paralysis. I think we only have 4 of those. Yeah, let me get like 4 more. Okay. I don't know if we can sleep here. I'm in trouble moving. Keep going. Go. No, we're back here. Oh my god. Go. Yeah, we can't sleep here. And we can't sleep in the town, apparently, either. At least as far as I know. I mean, maybe there's a way to sleep on the ship? I'm used to the Elder Scrolls. You just go up to a bed and click on it, and you can sleep on the bed. It doesn't work like that here. You have to rent a room. Alright, so let's heal our dog, since our dog cannot heal itself through peaceful sleep. Actually, the dog heal itself, but let's have Una heal it. Right, we'll test whether we can actually use the resonance spell of life heal with no repercussions. Oh, I didn't realize I even got hurt like that. Alright, so that's what I wanted to do, and we achieved it. Great. So Una's got a weapon again. We're kicking butt with monsters. I'm trying to move this way. Anyway, I'm going to call in an episode here. We'll proceed further into the fossil forest. See what kind of trouble we can get into. See if we can make it to that castle and talk to this queen. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.